Craig here from North 49, and are you a healthcare practitioner who is looking for a functional outcome measure for your patients who are dizzy? Well, if that's the case, this video is for you. In this video, we'll review our go-to functional outcome measure, being the Dizziness Handicap Inventory. Looks something like this. We'll review how to use it and how to interpret it. So with that in mind, let's see how it's done. With a Dizziness Handicap Inventory, really it evaluates how the dizziness is affecting people in three domains. Physically, so what increases the symptoms? Emotionally, because of symptoms, do you feel a particular way? And functionally, because of your symptoms, is it difficult to do a particular activity? So looking at the form here, if you look on the left-hand side, there is a number 1 to 25, so there's 25 questions, and right before the number there's three letters. It's either P, E, or F. So P stands for physical, E stands for emotional, and F stands for functional, right? And then how a patient scores this, actually let's read through the instructions first. The purpose of this scale is to identify difficulties that you may be experiencing because of your dizziness. Please answer yes, sometimes, or no to each item. Answer each item as it pertains to your dizziness or unsteadiness only. So if they have neck pain, you know, it shouldn't be related to the neck pain. It should be due to the dizziness or unsteadiness. So question number 1, it says, does looking up increase your problem? Yes, no, or sometimes. If it's yes, they take that off. If it's no, they take it off sometimes. And that would be, that's a physical problem. Number 2 is more of an emotional aspect or domain. Because of your problem, do you feel frustrated? Yes, no, or sometimes. Question number 3 is more of a functional, what they can't do as a result of the dizziness. So because of your problem, do you restrict your travel for business and recreation? Yes, no, or sometimes. So the patient goes through the list, the 25 questions, ticks off yes, no, or sometimes, and then you get it, and then you score it. For every yes, that's 4 points. For every sometimes, that's 2. And for every no, that's 0. So with scoring it, the total score, if they score 0, well, that's no perceived disability, obviously. If they score between 1 and 39%, that refers to mild perceived disability in regards to the dizziness. 40 to 69%, so if they score between there, that refers to moderate perceived disability. And if they score 70% or higher, that refers to severe perceived disability as a result of the dizziness. With the Dizziness Handicap Inventory, not only can we get a final score that helps us determine if they have mild, moderate, or severe perceived disability, but we can look at the scores and see if they scored more highly in the functional, emotional, or physical domain. So this test also has been found to have a good internal consistency and a high test, retest, reliability. So that is the Dizziness Handicap Inventory, a great functional measure to assess someone's perception of disability, also to see specifically what they're having difficulty with and tracking it over time. So if you like this video, feel free to like and subscribe, but also too, I'd ask you to check out our website at courses.north49therapy.com, where we have a whole bunch of other learning opportunities. Hope to see you there.